Okay, we're starting off with priming the eyelid, and the palette I'm going to use today, you of course don't need to use the exact same thing, but it's the Anastasia Beverly Hills Riviera palette. Because I've been walking around in the rain all day long, so I just want a little bit of a taste of summer. First off, I'm just tossing a transition shade onto my crease. Well, it's a bit pink for a transition, but it's a pale pink, basically. But yeah, like, don't get me wrong, I actually quite like winter. But especially after the holiday season is like gone, and then it's January, and then it's February, and it's like dreary and raining, and I get wet, and it's ugh, annoying. Well, at that point, I'm like, okay, let's just skip to summer, please, like now. And I don't control the weather, unfortunately, but I do control what my eyelids look like, so I can at least make it summer on my eyelids. Then to make it outer corner just a little bit more intense, I'm going in with a pink shade on a very small blending brush, and I'm really, really basically stamping it on the outer C shape here. And just basically applying enough that it's as opaque as I want, and then I'm just going to carefully tap it out. I don't want this to be too spread out. I really want this to be focused on that outer corner and just really increase the intensity. But I don't want the eyes to be too overpowering, because on the lips I'm going to use a glittery liquid lipstick, which I hope is going to look cool, but I've never tried it before, so I have no idea what it's going to look like. But we're just going to hope that it's actually awesome, because otherwise this entire look will be a mess. Then a brow bone highlight, I'm using a matte white shade. Also, by the way, talking about stuff with a cool color. Yesterday I did a little cooking experiment. I had a red cabbage, so I decided to make it into soup. Just using a little bit of the pale pink on my fluffy blender. But anyways, I made it into soup, and seriously, that stuff goes purple. I don't understand why they call it a red cabbage, because it's like, it was basically the color of my shirt, but then even more purple, like, I don't have to show you purple, you know what purple looks like. It was purple, it was so purple, like if you put it on a spoon, you couldn't even see the spoon anymore through the soup, because it was that purple. Like, it looked like it had gallons of like artificial coloring in it. But it didn't, it was all the red cabbage. It was awesome, like seriously. If you want to know a recipe or anything, you can always ask. Obviously, there was not just red cabbage in there. Also shared a little bit in a vlog, but I don't know if the vlog is up yet at this point. But seriously, it also tasted good. Like, I don't just recommend it for the color, it also actually tasted good, which for food is also sort of important, I suppose. But seriously, that color is awesome. Like, trust me, look it up, it's really cool. Anyway, cabbage colors aside, this is what we're gonna do for the eyelid. I'm going to use a shimmery pink first. More of a glittery pink, really. And put it in my outer corner, not too much. And then just carefully blend it inwards. And make sure it's also blended in the crease here. So you don't have a harsh edge. And then for the inner corner, just wiping down my brush real quick and going into the matte white shade and applying it on the inner corner of the eye and blending it towards the glitter. So that you get a bit of a ombre moment there. And a very bright inner corner. Now, next up is a pink eyeliner. With one catch, I don't actually own a pink eyeliner. So instead I dampened my, well, I'm just going to dampen it again a little bit. My angled brush, one of my angled brushes. And then in the left upper hand corner of the hot pink eyeshadow, I'm going to pick up some eyeshadow. The reason I do that in one corner of the eyeshadow is because liquid, any moisture, can actually badly affect the quality of the eyeshadows. And if you do it always in the same corner of the eyeshadow, then that's the only part of the pan that's going to potentially get damaged. So yeah, that's just why I do that. And then I'm just going to create a nice thin liner on top, which is just going to merge with the outer corner, because it's the same eyeshadow color. But it's just going to make the entire thing a little bit more interesting looking. Okay, that's on there. I'm just going to quickly do a BB cream on my face now, and then I'll return to you. It's possible with a BB cream, obviously, that you don't have enough coverage to your own taste at least. So I'm just adding a little bit of concealer where I want more. And then now that we're, you know, unpowdered for now anyways, I'm also going to apply a jelly highlighter. I used this for the first time in my last video. It's by NYX, and I love it, obviously. I'm using it again. It has this really, really gorgeous pearlescent shine. And also, it doesn't remove the foundation underneath, which is nice. So, I powdered as well, and now I'm just gonna do the bottom eyelid. Yeah. On the side of this brush, so it's nice and narrow, I'm just gonna put the dark pink color and apply it on the outer corner beneath my lashes. Just connecting it to the top part. I don't want this to thick, I just want it to exist, basically. And then back to small fluffy blender and the pale pink shade. And just pull a weird face while you use that to blend. Because this way you won't have wrinkles that you're going to put all the eyeshadow into, because that's exactly what you don't want, basically. Try to get it smooth. And then after wiping off the brush, I'm gonna grab way too much white eyeshadow. And apply said white shadow. White shadow? I just invented a new word. White eyeshadow in the inner corner to give yourself the brightest inner corner ever. Then for the waterline this time, I'm not even going for nude, I'm just going for straight up white, because the inner corner is white as well, so I just feel like it's a nice combination together. Okay, so far so good with the eyes. Now it's time to put the cherry on the cake and apply some falsies. So this is the before. And here is the after. This is the Soulmate by XO Beauty, which I picked because they're very nice and long and very eyelash extension-like. But they do have a clear lash band, so the thing that the individual hairs are stuck to is clear and not black. So it doesn't matter that you're not wearing black eyeliner. Perfect. I've also applied mascara on my top lashes to blend them with the falsies, and mascara on my bottom lashes because they were covered in concealer and powder and invisible at this point. So they're joining the game again. Now on to eyebrows. Now I'm just filling them in naturally, so I'm just using my brow pomade. I do have a pencil. I do think pencils are very easy to use. But I never use the pencil because even though the pencil I have is the NYX Brow Powder Pencil, and I love the consistency of it. Only the color is bright orange. Like, I want the ginger shade, but I didn't really want bright, bright orange. Which it is, so yeah, like, I'm just waiting for the lockdown to end, so the stores will open again, and I can actually go look at eyebrow pencils in real life. I don't like ordering things like that online, just because I always feel... I'm just spreading it in the jar. But anyways, I always just feel like there's just too many variables, I should say. Like, what settings was the camera on? What settings is my computer screen on? So something might look way warmer or way cooler on camera. And then look completely different in real life, which... I don't know, it's just a bit risky to me, so... yeah, I'm just gonna wait with it until I can actually physically see the pencil again before buying it. Okay, natural brows are done. You could set the hairs in place with a brow gel or something like that, but my completely damp bangs are pinned back, so there's nothing that's gonna push my eyebrow hairs out of shape. Anyway, I'm going to apply a pink blush, and after that, just a quick setting spray. Oh, by the way, this is the Catrice Defining Blush in 040 Think Pink. I've had it for so long that even though the name is faded off, I still just completely remember it. This thing is ancient, so you might not actually be able to find this anymore, but any pink blush will do. Now, the liquid lipstick that I'm going to use is NYX Glitter Goals Liquid Lipstick, which I got from a photographer. So, yeah, basically, once I finally can get to applying makeup on models again, I do want to use this on a model, but I do want to use it on myself first, so I know what to expect. The thing is, this is supposed to be one of those lipsticks that you apply, and then you do... and you suddenly have glitter lips, so I'm very curious. Okay, so this is what it looks like before I've done the... smacking thing. I just made that sound weird. Anyway, I'm gonna pull you up a little bit closer so you can actually see well. Okay, so we're uncomfortably close now. I'm just holding a mirror so I can actually see as well. The glitter is already very visible. That might be because I applied it with a brush because of hygiene. And so I already rubbed over it. Also, yes, my application is not the best. I know. Sorry. Anyway, but I do really love the color. It's nice and opaque. It's very, very pretty. So yeah, let's do the thing and see what happens. Wow. Okay, seriously, I expected something of Nyx. But I didn't expect this. Like, seriously, it's wow. It's full on glitter. Like, it's, oh, I really hope the camera picks this up as glittery as it is in real life. It's absolutely gorgeous. Like, seriously, it's so glittery. I want to go look online and like buy like 5 different shades of this. This one is a shade Cherry Quartz, by the way. It's seriously wow. I love it. I seriously love it. And yeah, I was looking at my face like, was there something else I needed to do? But I think I look pretty much complete, so we're done. And here we have the final results. So yeah, that's it for today. Stuff I wanted to mention. Oh right, if you enjoyed this video, please click the like button. It would really help me out because it makes YouTube recommend my video to new people more often. Is my camera in focus? I feel like my camera hates me every now and then. I haven't even done anything to it lately. Anyway, you can also subscribe to my channel if you want to see more of my struggles with my camera, but mostly makeup tutorials. You might see this glitter gold thing in multiple colors in the future, because I definitely am gonna buy more, because I love glitter and this is like a new favorite product. Seriously, wow. I just can't stop looking at it. But yeah, anyways, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye!